Greetings. Let's take a look at a question from Islam. Is Jesus God or the Son of God? If you cannot give me a simple answer, then please don't bother replying. He demanded a simple answer, so I gave him the simplest one I could. Both. And I know I risked being flippant, but he demanded simple. So the Father and the Son died on the cross. And this is honestly a big problem communicating with those in Islam. The demand for simple dictums and sound bites can cripple discussion of any depth. And you must realize this is part of Satan's plan as the Al-Makr. But we must present the truth in love. So I replied, Brother, you ask a serious and deep question, and I truly desire to give you a clear and full answer. However, the understanding of the answer you seek to your question will only be understood by someone who reads and respects the prophets of God. You have said you want simple answers, but the God who made heaven and earth is not a simple story told by men. As I said, you have to read and consider what the prophets have said. The foundation which is easy to lay is that Jesus is the Son of God, foretold by the prophets. The prophets foretell of the Son of God. Prophet Solomon said in Proverbs 34, Who hath ascended up unto heaven, or descended? Who hath gathered the wind in his fists? Who has bound the waters in a garment? Who has established all the ends of the earth? What is his name? And what is his son's name, if you can tell? Notice Prophet Solomon asked, What is his son's name, if you can tell? Prophet David said in Psalms 2:7, I will declare the decree the Lord hath said unto me, Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. Prophet David revealed the declaration God told him to declare. This is like the Quran saying, Say! And more in Psalms 2:11, Serve the Lord with fear and rejoice with trembling. Kiss the Son, lest he be angry and you perish from the way, when his wrath is kindled but a little. Blessed are all they that put their trust in him, meaning the Son of God. You have read Isaiah 9:6, but choose to believe God would tell a prophet to call the son of Hezekiah Mighty God and Everlasting Father. But Prophet Isaiah was revealing the Son of God who would be given the title of and spoken about as the Mighty God. Jesus came declaring he was the Son of God, and Satan challenged Jesus with the temptation to see if Jesus could be tempted to commit sin. Because if Jesus could be tempted into committing the sin, Jesus was not the Son of God, nor was Jesus God. But Jesus could not be tempted into sin, proving he was the Son of God. The second fact to confirm Jesus was the Son of God was that God spoke from the clouds, declaring, This is my beloved Son, hear him. Mark 9:7, And there was a cloud that overshadowed them, and a voice came out of the cloud, saying, This is my beloved Son, hear him. Luke 9:35, And there came a voice out of the cloud, saying, This is my beloved Son, hear him. So if Almighty God, speaking for all to hear, says Jesus is his beloved Son, do you believe God, my Muslim brother? Or do you really want to call God a liar? I know, brother, you want to convince me that you honor God. Please try to understand why those words are hollow to me. The depth of understanding takes another step, my friend, when you read what Jesus said about his own existence. Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Jesus said he was the only way to get to God. He did not say he was only for his generation. He did not say until Muhammad or Ahmad came later. John 14:7, if you had known me, you should have known my Father also, and from henceforth you know him and have seen him. Jesus said by knowing him, by knowing Jesus, you know God. John 5:17, but Jesus answered them, my Father worketh hitherto, and I work. Therefore the Jews sought the more to kill him, because he not only had broken the Sabbath, but said also that God was his Father, making himself equal with God. Jesus called himself the Son of God, which made him equal with God. John 5:26, for as the Father has life in himself, so has he given to the Son to have life in himself. John 10:18, no man taketh it from me, but I lay it down of myself. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This commandment have I received of my Father. Jesus said he lays down his life. He controlled his own death. Can a man say this, or can only God say this? And I have power to take it again. Jesus said he has power to take up his life after he has laid it down. Jesus is saying that he can raise himself back from the dead if he wants to. John 10:15, as the Father knoweth me, even so know I the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. Jesus says he knows God as well as God, the all-knowing, knows him. Who can possibly know God as well as God knows them? Only God. John 17:2, as thou God has given him, the Son, power over all flesh, that he, the Son, should give eternal life to as many as thou hast given him. Jesus said he has the power to give eternal life. Who but God has the power to give eternal life? John 5:22, for the Father judgeth no man, but has committed all judgment unto the Son. Jesus said that God will not judge you, brother. Jesus said that God has given him all judgment. There are many more things that Jesus said about himself, brother. Maybe in future letters I will go into more detail for you. Getting back to the question of is Jesus God, you have to examine the prophets and what they said about God, and then consider the historical fact that Jesus fulfilled these passages ascribed to God. Example 1. Prophet David said in Psalm 107:28, then they cry unto the Lord in their trouble, and he bringeth them out of their distress. He maketh the storm a calm, so that the waves thereof are still. And in Mark 4:38, and he was in the hinder part of the ship, asleep on a pillow, and they awoke him, and said unto him, Master, carest thou not that we perish? Verse 39, and he arose and rebuked the wind, and said unto the sea, peace, be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. So in Psalm 107:28, they cry unto the Lord, the Hebrew word being Yahweh, or God. You can study enough to look this up and see that I do not tell a lie. Psalm 107:28 speaks of God. They cry unto God, and God calms the storm and stills the waves. Then they seek Jesus. They wake him up to ask, don't you care that we perish, that we're about to die? And Jesus rebukes the storm and calms the wave. Jesus did what the prophets said God would do. Then example 2. Prophet Isaiah spoke of the voice in the wilderness who would announce God in the earth. Isaiah 40:3, the voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Again, Lord is Yahweh, and God is the general term Eloheinu, which is used in the Shema of Israel. Later, when the Jewish leaders challenged John the Baptist, who Islam calls Yahya, John said that he was the voice of one crying out, meaning John was the one who fulfilled what prophet Isaiah said. John 1:19, and this is the record of John when the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him, "Who art thou?" Verse 23, he said, "I am a voice of one crying in the wilderness, make straight the way of the Lord, as Isaiah the prophet said." This means John claimed he was announcing Yahweh was coming. Yahweh was coming to the earth. Yahweh is the being Christians know is the triune God, but you may think is only God the Father. Either way, John announced God and said he was the voice to announce God. And John announced Jesus. These two prophets, speaking 1,000 years apart at God's command, establish that Jesus is Yahweh, my friend. And a third example for you to consider. Prophet Zechariah wrote in Zechariah 12:8, "In that day shall the Lord, Yahweh, God, defend the inhabitants of Jerusalem. And he that is feeble among them at that day shall be as David, and the house of David shall be as God, as the angel of the Lord before them. And it shall come to pass in that day that I will seek to destroy all the nations that come against Jerusalem. And I, Yahweh, God, will pour out upon the house of David and upon the inhabitants of Jerusalem the spirit of grace and supplications, and they shall look upon me," this is Yahweh, God, "whom they have pierced, and they shall mourn for him as one mourneth for his only son, and he shall be in bitterness for him as one that is in bitterness for his firstborn. They, Israel, will look upon Yahweh, Almighty God, their defender, whom they, the Jews, have pierced." This is what the prophets foretold, brother. The Jews would pierce God. And I know that seems an impossible thing, except the prophet of God has spoken it. I pray you would seriously consider what the prophets have said, brother. Does it disrespect God to know what the prophets said and give his message thought and consideration? I don't think so. I pray that you, dear viewer, would respect the message of the prophets. I pray that you would meditate on what the prophets have said and what it means. If you call yourself Muslim, I believe you want to show God respect. Answer the cry in your heart to honor the one true living God. Call out to the God of heaven and earth. Call out to him with tears of repentance. Call out to him and ask him to reveal himself to you. And the one true God will answer your true heart's cry. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.